It says in the beginning of our parasha, parashat ki tisah, the Holy Torah said to us, every man shall give Hashem an atonement for his soul when counting them, so that there will not be a plague among them when counting them. Later on, few psukim, it says, and you shall take the silver of the atonement from Klal Yisrael. And it's mind-boggling. How come? If they give, what the reason to take? And if there is need to take, for sure nobody gave. But Bar Minan, we're going to try to explain it. Some people, Chas v'chalila, the only way to bring them to Daven in Shul, that's mean that somebody close relative died. And others, they awaken to give charity only when themselves going to come already to the hospital to a serious treatment. So Hashem gave, say to us, and gave the true advice, and they should give the atonement for their soul. If you gave willingly, with happiness, with true belief, you're not going to come to any stage of heart diseases, even corona. As it says, there will be no plague. That's why later on it says, and you should take the money of the atonement. If there's need to take, and a person doesn't want to give willingly, then there's need to atone on your soul. You will have to give when there is already, chas v'chalila, trouble, pain, and misery. Another precise learning from the words venatnu, that if you're going to look on the word venatnu, from the beginning and the end, it is pronounced exactly the same, to teach us that the world is a turning wheel. And sometimes a person today can be very rich and chas v'chalila tomorrow lose everything. And the same to the poor. And God forbid, if right now you give and you got, for sure, if you're going to need chas v'chalila, you will get. And also it's learned from Esav HaRasha, when it says in the Pasuk, Vayave Le'aviv, these two words, Vayave Le'aviv, it's pronounced and written exactly the same from beginning to the end. Also to him that if you give to your father, the father in heaven, even a Jew that is not so good, is a little bit bad. If you give to Hashem and want to come close, Hashem is going to come close to you right away and bring you closer to him. The Holy Torah continued and said to us, that the wealthy shall not increase and the destitute, the poor, shall not decrease, to teach that the point that right now you reach, it's not any obligation that you got some kind of true quality or you're a very successful or wise person. You got no reason to be haughty. And the same to the other way. Dear poor person, don't feel that you got no value, because you could be very smart and successful and true Ben Torah and true server of Hashem. Because everything we know is in the hand of heaven, except the fear of heaven. And before even the person is born, when he just conceived, decided, are you going to be rich or poor? Another very important learning, also right now before Purim, from these two psukim, that the rich person not going to think that he can hold and have more for himself because he's holding and he's cheap and doesn't give. And also the poor person, don't think you should not give. You should decrease what you're giving because you don't have a lot. Because every Jew is obligated to give and support one another. And no Jew going to come and get to him any mischief when truthfully he give and spread the wealth that Hashem gave to him. If it's monetary, spiritually, just in listening ear sometimes. Have a beautiful Shabbat, meaningful Shabbat, Nachat Ruach Klal Yisrael, health to everybody who need and true salvation and redemption right now.